Good afternoon. Thank you all for being here. Last week, our city experienced, in one moment, two of the most horrific experiences that a community can endure. In one moment, we experienced an officer who was injured by gunfire in our community, and in that same moment, we experienced an officer-involved shooting. Either one of those, taken in isolation, would stretch our city, would stretch our police department to a great degree. Both of those together are a challenging incident that leaves our city with complex layers of grief to unpack and to process. We are fortunate and grateful that in this instance, the injuries to our Officer Cheetah were non-life-threatening. Our prayers, of course, continue to be with him and with his family as he recovers from that incident. And we also know that we lost a community member at the same time. We also know that that reality is traumatizing to many of us in community and also to every single one of our police officers who, you know, every single one of whom would say they would do anything they can to prevent instances like this from happening. And I'm confident that none of us would ever want to find ourselves in that situation. As has been our case, as has been our practice since the beginning of my administration, we are working with the BCA, the Minnesota Bureau of Criminal Apprehension, who will be the investigators in this incident. They are investigating and moving forward. We are working with them to ensure a timely, thorough, and transparent investigation. We've talked with many of you for years about our community first public safety framework, of which transparency is a core tenet. Trust cannot be built, cannot be established, cannot be protected in the dark, which is why transparency is such a core function. Releasing body cam footage so that our community members can understand what transpired on that day as a core part of our transparency strategy. Our practice has always been that we release body camera footage as soon as possible upon the ability of our investigating partners, in this case the BCA, to collect all of the preliminary witness statements and the ability of the family of the deceased to view the tape. We can all remember times when that process, we would count that process in months and in years. I'm really fortunate and really grateful to our police department and to the BCA for working together to forge a reality just over the past several years where we can count that time in days. That's an important investment in transparency. That's an important investment to move us forward. I'm sure that many of our community members will have many questions about the events that transpired last week, some of which will be answered by viewing the video, but certainly not all of which. That's where the BCA's investigation comes in. That's where the process and time that it takes to conduct a thorough investigation comes in. And that's frankly one of the reasons why neither I nor the chief is going to be able to even attempt to resolve all of those questions in this press conference. This conversation right now is about delivering this video so that people can see for themselves what transpired last week and so that we can continue to move forward as a community, as a city, with our community first public safety framework in a way that allows our community to heal, our community to process our trauma and grief that we're experiencing as a result of the events of last week, and to continue moving forward together. With that, I'll introduce, and I have with me St. Paul Police Chief Axel Henry and the Director of our Office of Neighborhood Safety, Brooke Blakey. And with that, I will bring to the microphone our Police Chief Axel Henry.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
As the mayor so perfectly stated, the death of anyone in our community is always sad and upsetting. And regardless of the circumstances, we know here in St. Paul that the loss of any life is tragic. We're keeping the family and friends of Mr. Keyes in our thoughts, and we can greatly appreciate the fact that they are grieving the loss of a loved one. We also stay completely committed to our officer as he recovers from his injuries. None of us in our community want incidents like this to happen. None of us. And while we recognize this very early in this investigation, we hope that our city's commitment, as the mayor so perfectly described, and the release of body camera footage will help create at least some clarity around some of the facts that we know very early on. I'm extremely grateful to the BCA for their understanding of our desire here in St. Paul to provide our community with information sooner rather than later, whenever that's possible. Again, we have to respect their investigation, and we don't want our request to impede that investigation, but they have been great partners, and again, they have demonstrated that by being allowing us to be able to do this so swiftly. We know that the events that transpired on Thursday were having a lasting effect in our community, and particularly to our first responders, including our officers, paramedics, dispatchers, and our professional staff. Healing is a process that takes time, patience, and support. But we stand here as one community, and we will do everything we can to support one another while the BCA completes this investigation. I thank everyone in our community in advance for your patience while the BCA conducts this independent investigation. And that's the independent process that we as a community has asked them to do. Thank you so very much.